colonised by the British. Down through the years, there have been a number of unsuccessful attempts to overthrow the British. In 1916, with the British busy fighting in World War I, a group of men and women decided to lead a rising against the British. This rising would take place in Dublin during Easter. The rising itself wasn't successful, but started a series of events that led to the formation of the Republic of Ireland.
Where am I? What's going on? Wait, this looks like a meeting of the leaders of the 1916 Rising.
The Rising cannot go ahead on Easter Sunday. The boat carrying all of our arms has been scuttled.
We have to notify the rest of the insurgents that the Rising has been postponed. We'll place an ad in the Independent telling people that all the marches have been called off. They'll know what we mean.
Don't worry. On Easter Monday at midday, the Rising will go ahead with whatever forces we can gather.
It doesn't look as if there are many people here. Only around 1,500. Probably the confusion over the change of date reduced the number of rebels.
We're going out to be slaughtered.
Looks like the rebels have taken over some of Dublin's most important buildings. The Four Courts. The Jacobs Factory. Bolland's Mill. South Dublin Union Workhouse. The College of Surgeons. And City Hall. They almost took Dublin Castle, which would have been strategically very important. They set up headquarters in the General Post Office, the GPO. What's happening here? Oh, it looks like the press is reading the proclamation, declaring Ireland a republic, independent from the British.
The Irish Republic is entitled to, and hereby claims, the allegiance of every Irishman and Irishwoman. The Republic guarantees religious and civil liberty, equal rights and equal opportunities to all its citizens, and declares it resolved to pursue the happiness and prosperity of the whole nation on all of its parts, cherishing all of the children of the nation equally and oblivious of differences carefully fostered by an alien government, which have divided the minority from majority in the past.
British Brigadier General Law arrived today and proclaimed martial law in Dublin. He ordered British troops to surround the city and trap the rebels in. He is focusing an attack on the GPO. I don't think it will be long before more British troops arrive. I hear a gunboat called the Helge is on its way to Dublin right now. Here comes the British now. There's thousands of them. I don't think the rebels stand a chance. The fighting has been going on for 5 days now. The streets are closed off and the GPO is on fire. It looks like we're outnumbered greatly by the British. There's far too many to tell.
We need to evacuate now. There's too many and the roof is about to cave in. Arahu, you lead the men out.
Written after I was shot, Dad and Nancy, I was shot leading a rush up Moore Street and took refuge in the doorway. While I was there, I heard the men pointing out where I was and made a bolt for the lane I am in now. I got more than one bullet, I think. Tons and tons of love, dearie, to you and the boys, and to Nell and Annie. It was a good fight anyhow. Please deliver this to Nanny O'Reilly, 40 Herbert Park, Dublin. Goodbye, darling.
The rest of the men made it to O'Hanlon's fish shop on Moore Street.
The British troops have surrounded us. We're going to have to surrender. Elizabeth, you go out with the white flag and let General Lowe know we're coming out.
Okay, I'll negotiate with him and see what conditions we can get.
Followed with a letter from Pierce. In order to prevent the further slaughter of Dublin citizens, members of the provisional government agreed to unconditional surrender. There's been talk that the leaders of the Rising are being executed here in Kilmainham jail. Word is that Connolly was so badly injured he had to be tied to the chair to be shot. I never thought about how much the Easter Rising had to do with our history. Even though the rebellion was a failure, it influenced so many other events. It was the stepping stone to our independence. As if executioner leaders were seen as heroes in the eyes of the Irish people, we have a lot to thank them for today.